Previously on The Mole. Nine players began a series of tasks raising money for the pot that the winner will eventually take home. The current pot is at $47. However, one of these players is the mole, hired by me to secretly sabotage the group's efforts. It's up to the players to figure out who the mole is, because at the end of each round, they have to take a 10-question quiz on the mole's identity. The player with the lowest score in the quiz is executed and must leave the game immediately.
We are going to have a quick vote. I want you guys to vote for who you would like to see go home next.
Oh.
Who do you want to see go home next?
Oh. No.
What is that?
He's a babe.
Babe.
Okay.
Marissa.
Oh.
Marissa.
Oh.
And Gabe. Alright, so Gabe,
yeah,
you were voted that you
Marissa?
Want to see.
Oh,
you
Anna.
Want to be seen going home next. And you get an exemption, which means you made it to the next round. So you're going to be sleeping in our luxury suite upstairs in Brian's room alone instead of in the crowded basement. And you don't have to do test number 7. Does anyone here know what a flamingo contest is?
Standing on one leg?
Yes.
Oh, no!
All right, I'm
going to
put the
timer
here so you guys can
start the movie.
Oh, my God.
Task 7 was very boring, to say the least. I mean, it wasn't very, like, exhilarating in any sort of way, and it wasn't very hard.
It's okay, I got this one.
We got a possible $8 out of $10, because Marissa and Anna messed up trying to get up and down.
So for this task, you're all, instead of working as a group for money, this time you're just going to work as individuals, playing for the chance to use your notebook on the next execution quiz, because everyone else is not allowed to use their notebook. Go!
Oh, geez.
Marissa was pretty far ahead, and now Alina's coming back.
Yeah.
Now, Marissa, because you won, you have the chance to use your notebook during the quiz. Or you can add $3 to the pot and make it even $50.
No, I want my notebook.
You want your notebook?
Wow, second time she took it.
And I chose to use my notebook instead of add $3 to the pot, and they all hate me again.
I'm surprised that Marissa opted to take her notebook instead of the money, which makes me have more suspicions on her.
This is like not the first time she's not like taken like something for herself instead of the money.
Sam. You're the most victim. Please come with me.
Four players remain, but only one will win. The one who answers the question, who is the mole? Can you figure it out? Who is the mole?
Sam just got executed, and it was the first one, and nobody was suspecting that. But, yeah, somebody had to go home. I don't know, I guess I was a little shocked, but I felt like Sam had her time coming to her, because last round, she said, if I don't get out, then I don't know what's going on, because she said that the test was really hard. So this time I kind of figured it was going to be her.
Wasn't really surprised considering how frantic she was being, but now I know she's not the mole, so I really have no idea who the mole is.
No.
No.
Any suspicions?
They're all equally suspicious.
I did not think I was going to make it through the last elimination. Like, I really don't have any clue of who the mole's going to be.
Any suspicions?
I'm thinking Alina, maybe, because she's been very under the radar lately. So I'm thinking maybe she would be... I'm really suspicious of all of them, so it's going to be difficult.
Still, like, now it's the final four. It's weird.
Yeah.
I want to make it to the final, the top three, I think.
Do you think you're going to?
I hope so. I hope the tasks this time are not that hard. If but they probably will be. And the test is going to be really hard, too.
I don't know. I think my days are numbered now.
What's your strategy going to be to keep yourself in?
Hopefully, if there's an exemption, you know, to get it. But, I mean, other than that, just try my best.
It's weird how Marissa keeps doing things for herself.
She does.
Sabotage almost.
We lost a lot of money.
If we don't get any money this round, I feel like this is one of those things where it's like you have to guess it right in order to get the money, and that would be Marissa's job. So if we don't get a lot of money,
she definitely won't.
Yeah.
Agreed.
Totally.
We lost so much money
because of her.
How much money did we lose?
We lost like six bucks because of her. She took the exemption.
And then
the flamingo thing.
The flamingo
too. Like 10 bucks.
And then exemption thing.
Yeah.
Oh wait, you said that.
Yeah.
There was another one.
The opinion thing was.
The opinion thing was like.
That was tough to call.
Okay, congratulations. You guys are the final four in the game. But as you all know, one of you four is the mole. So we're going to continue with test number 9, where you'll have a chance to add $6 to the pot. So before we start, I need you guys to pick one person who's the best at giving instructions, one person who's the best at matching, one person who's the best at drawing, and one person who has the best eye for art. Eye for art, like looking at art.
Oh, is it like, it's gonna be like pictionary. If someone has to draw.
Alright, so best eye for art, best at giving instructions.
Alright, then I guess I'll guess.
It's best at matching, best at giving instructions, best at drawing, best at.
Okay.
Best at. Okay, so who has the best eye for art? You?
Yeah.
Okay, so come with me. Up to pick one piece of art from this 8-picture gallery that we've set up.
For what?
We just can't tell you that. Just pick one piece of art. Okay, thank you. You can go upstairs, call, and what she picks up, tell me, and we will begin.
Oh my god, I'm nervous. I'm so nervous.
Is it on speaker?
Mm-hmm.
Just...
Hello?
Hi.
30 seconds, starts now.
Okay. The picture is just of a woman, just her face, no profile or anything, just like straightforward. And the picture's pretty small, and she has really short hair, and there's like lots of color.
Short, like
to her ear, just like ear length.
Hello?
Time has started. Go.
Oh, are you
kidding? Time is up.
That's it? Okay.
Yep.
So just...
You have less than 3 minutes to draw. Go.
No, I'm trying to make her look like a girl. I don't want her to look like a man. Because it's a female. It's colorful, so I have to make it. Okay, this is good.
Good?
Yeah.
Okay.
Alright, Gabe, whatever you'd like. Okay, so Gabe, we had one person choose one of these 8 photos, another person give instructions on the photo that was chosen, and the third person, Anna, draw it. So here's her drawing. You have 1 minute to try to match it with the picture. So your 1 minute starts now. Use all the time you need. You still have 30 seconds, so you can keep thinking. It's for $6. So it's big. Okay? Alright. So, we had Marissa come down and choose one of these 8 portraits over here. And then she handed that off to Alina, who, in the dark, had to describe it for 30 seconds over phone with Anna.
In the dark?
Yes.
Yeah.
Then Anna had 3 minutes to draw it, and she came out with this lovely drawing. And Gabe had to try to match that with the picture. So, Marissa, why don't you come over and show everyone the picture that you chose without reacting, Gabe. Okay. And Gabe, which picture did you choose? He chose that one. Congratulations.
Yay.
So you guys got $6 added to the pot, which means the winner now takes home $53.
Yeah.
Randomly guessed out of all those pictures, miraculously got it right. Don't know how that happened.
There was a lot of speculation that you were going to pick the Marilyn Monroe. What made you choose otherwise?
Well, there were a couple of things that looked more like the other picture, like the drawbridge of the nose and like the shoulders. Apparently, the drawer did not mean to draw those, so we got lucky, I guess.
Wish it was just all girls, because on the test when it says, is the mole male or female, it's
yeah.
like, but what if Gabe's the mole? And I'm getting that question wrong every single time. So.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's so annoying.
Yeah.
You were trash talking to
you. Anna, do you have two people?
Who's trash talking me? Which one of you?
All of us.
Damn it.
Okay. Trash talking right to his face. Did you guys think Gabe was gonna make it that far?
No.
You think Gabe was gonna be the first one out?
I think I voted him out like the first one. In the first test though,
so. Who do you think was gonna be the first one out?
I voted Alina.
Ooh.
Really?
Yeah.
Marissa had to pick a picture for me to draw, and she just said to me that she kinda knew what was going on. And she picked one of the hardest pictures for me to draw. So that makes me kinda suspicious.
As the only junior.
I know.
And Anna's the only one not in our friend group, too.
Yeah.
Not, no offense,
Anna. I've been
Anna.
Thinking about that. Like, how did she get this far and not really, like,
know anybody?
Oh,
yeah.
Suspicious.
Okay. Well, we're about to start a trash talk.
We're trying to see
you. Marissa picked a picture, and then I had to describe it to Anna, who had to draw it, and then Gabe had to match the picture to Anna's drawing, and I had to describe it to Anna for 30 seconds on the phone, but I was in the dark and I could barely see anything. But in the end, they ended up picking the right picture anyway, so we got more money for the pot.
I don't know, because we're not like all together in the tasks, so I can't really see who's being suspicious and who's not being, but Gabe could have easily sabotaged us. Because he was the one picking the picture at the end. So, yeah, that was kind of suspicious, I guess.
I was a little suspicious that Marissa would choose something so difficult because the picture definitely could have been Marilyn Monroe. I feel like she could have chosen an easier picture to choose to draw, so.
She's the mole?
I didn't say that, but she's definitely suspicious.
Who I think is most suspicious? Alina. I suspected her from the beginning. I still suspect her now. I had her down as the mole in the beginning, and I'm sticking with it. But in the test, I do like half and half, because don't want to put all my bet on her, because, like, what if she's not? Then I'm completely wrong. So I do like half. I do half her and half Gabe. The fact that Gabe picked the right picture, like, there were two women that it could have been that for what I drew. Like, I drew a woman's face. And he picked the right one. Like, it could have been Marilyn Monroe or this other one. And he picked the right one, which makes me a little less suspicious of him. So I think Marissa is, like, my guess right now.
No, I don't trust anyone. Anna's on my hit list, too. Everyone's on my hit list.
It's time for the last task of the rounds before one of you must go home. The pot is now $53, and you have a chance to make that $59. So for this task, you have to split up into two groups, the three people who are the smartest and the one dumb person in the group. So
what?
Divide yourself up. Who do you think is the dumbest?
What does it mean?
Talk about it. You have a minute or two.
Does anyone want to say that they're the dumbest?
I think
Just say it.
Well, maybe because, like, Anna's the least experienced.
Yeah, okay, I'll be the dumbest.
I really didn't have a say. Marissa just kind of said Anna, and I was like, you know what? Sure.
Dumb with that.
Okay.
Yeah. Anna, I'm not saying you're the dumbest, but I'm just saying we're, like, older, so we have more experience.
Yeah, no, I know what you mean. I'll be the dumbest. Yeah.
Okay. All right, so Anna, you're the dumbest. You come with me, and the rest of you can
sit at
the
table.
So Anna, they voted for you as the dumbest player in the group, but the joke might be on them because you have a chance at an exemption right now. So what we have here is 10 mental puzzles, some of them very easy, like number one, and some of them very difficult. So it's up to you to pick 6 puzzles for them, and for each puzzle that they solve in their 10-minute period, $1 will be added to the pot. However, if they don't solve 4 or more puzzles, you will get an exemption. So you get to decide which 6 puzzles they get. We're gonna give you the chance to add one more puzzle into this for a chance at $7 instead of 6, making it go up to $60 if they get all 7, but you wouldn't have the chance at the exemption. So you can make that choice now. They won't know whether or not you choose this. So you can give up the exemption chances and add one more dollar to the pot.
No, I want the exemption.
You want the exemption?
Yeah.
Okay, well, time is up. So you guys, because you're the 3 smartest, will have 10 minutes to solve the 6 following puzzles. For each puzzle that you correctly solve, $1 is added to the pot. Your time starts now. What the fuck?
Do you want to divide?
Do we write on these? You can write on them in your notebook for scrap. Just make sure you
can sit right on here.
Can we sit?
Yes.
Is that okay?
You can bring over a chair if
you
I did this one.
Yeah.
And this one, I just wild guessed.
Okay, right. Look at hers first.
Because there's like nothing on it.
Yeah.
That one's a long reading
one.
Okay.
This one's not hard, it's just annoying.
So then I wrote it out in words.
Okay. Look at that one. I think what you wrote is what I would have said.
Okay.
So this one's like math.
That one is entirely math.
Yeah.
Who wrote Pull the Trigger?
Me.
10 seconds.
Time's up.
Starting off with what the smartest had to do, the 3 of you guys had 10 minutes to complete 6 puzzles, and you completed 5 of them, so we'll first go over the one that you did not get, and it was $1 per puzzle. So you had the question with the 2 cakes, and how does they get to grandma's with exactly 2 cakes?
Was it 2?
The answer is 2 cakes, because every time they would lose one and then gain another. The players are told that they solved a total of 4 out of the 6 puzzles, making the pot $57. Anna, however, does not receive an exemption because 4 of the puzzles were solved. Anna had a choice of 10 puzzles, all of different difficulties, in front of her to start, and she had to choose 6 of them for you to solve. But the twist was, if you guys didn't solve 4 or more, then she would get an exemption. However, you guys did solve 4, so she does not get an exemption and will have to take this quiz. So, she did in fact choose some of the harder caliber problems for you guys to do.
So we had to go into 2 groups, 1 stupid person, and then 3 smart people, and then Anna was picked as the dumbest.
Did you agree with that decision?
I agreed that she was the youngest and had the least amount of experience, but I don't think she's a dumb person at all.
If you stuck to your gut, who would you have picked?
Oh, I don't know.
That's a mean question.
Confess.
No, I'm not gonna confess that. No.
Confess.
No.
Confess.
I didn't get an exemption because I really want to be in the final three. So I'm upset that they solved all 4 out of 6.
How'd you feel about being called the dumbest?
Well, I didn't really mind because it was based on my age because I am the youngest out of them. So, I mean, that didn't really bother me, but I don't know. I wasn't at an advantage because I was called the dumbest, but still.
I'm not gonna confess.
Confess.
It's mean.
I don't care. No. This is the mole.
Well, I have to go to school with these people afterwards. I have to, like, look at them. No, I'm not gonna do it. Do people say mean things about me?
Duh.
I got one of them, but the other one that I did, I got it wrong.
Did you?
I forgot about the human.
I got pretty much all the riddles right that I did. I got the cake wrong. Thought for sure that involved a lot of math. Did not. So, now I feel stupid. Maybe I should have been the dumb one.
How are the puzzles that you did?
They were hard. I did get one completely right that I ended up doing. And then everybody just kind of like shared their puzzles to see if they could get all of them right. We ended up getting 4 out of 6, and then Anna did not get an exemption because we got 4 out of 6.
Did you like having to decide in the beginning who was the smartest and who was the dumbest?
No, because now they think I'm mean.
So you think
I didn't call her the dumbest, okay? I said she was the less experienced because she was the youngest.
It's now time for Execution Quiz 5, 10 questions about the mole's identity. The player with the lowest score on this quiz will be the mole's 6th victim. Question number 1, is the mole male or female?
So who was suspicious that round?
Anna, because she picked hard riddles for us. So if you can get an exemption.
2. What grade is the mole in?
So you're kind of laying off Alina right now?
Alina's probably the mole. If I'm focusing on those two, my luck would be she's the mole.
Yeah.
So we'll see. Trust. Maybe I'll be around for another round. Hopefully. If I can make it to the final three, that'd be cool.
3. In task 9, what was the mole's job?
Do you think you're going to do well on this quiz?
No.
Are you going to make it to the final three?
I hope so. I really want to. But I think the quiz is going to be really hard.
4. In task 9, did the mole see any of the original pictures?
Well, it would make sense for Anna to want an exemption, because everybody wants an exemption. So, I mean, it's a little suspicious that she would just give us all the hard ones, but I don't know, it's tough to say.
5. In task 9, did the mole ever have to choose a picture?
Same strategy I have been using, because it's been working well. Just keep to myself and be very observant.
6. In task 9, was the mole ever on the phone?
For the test that I'm going to take, I have 2 people in my mind that I'm going to probably base the answers on. Alina and Marissa. And then we'll see how that goes.
Did they do anything noticeably suspicious in the last round?
No, because I didn't really see them the last round, but just Alina's been very under the radar, so I feel like she's going to try to sneak through and like be the mole. So.
7. In task 10, which group is the mole in?
That is probably one of the smartest out of the remaining players. That was a little suspicious of Marissa to pick her, but Anna did kind of volunteer to be the dumb one too, so really suspicious on both accounts.
8. What is the mole's notebook number?
Anna's the least one I suspect, but then I'm like, maybe I should watch out for her, because she is a junior.
Reverse psychology.
Yeah.
9. Up to date, has the mole received an exemption?
I'm shocked I made it this far. I mean, I was just hoping not to get out in the first round.
Now you have a chance for $53.
Oh my god.
In question number 10, who is the mole?
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, no.
Well, one of you is about to become the mole's sixth victim, and will not have a chance to win the $57. So, let's get started. Gabe.
Dun, 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 dun.
Gabe, you're safe. And you've made it to the finals. Marissa.
Oh.
Marissa, you're safe.
Uh-oh.
That means we're down to two. Anna and Rita. One of you is about to become the mole's sixth victim. Who would like to have their envelope opened?
Me.
Anna?
Yeah.
Okay. Anna. Anna, I'm sorry. You are the sixth victim.
We're gonna last forever.
Anna, wow. Please come with me.
Alright, so she's not the mole.
Yes.
Yeah, one of you three are.
That's so.
Which ones are you mole training right now?
She got out?
Yeah.
Oh, Anna.
Anna, how do you feel about being the mole's sixth victim?
I'm upset because I wanted to be in the final three, but no. Sorry, I got far enough.
Oh, girls who are, like, rich, like...
Girls who are rich, like, pompous, okay. I've never seen...
Like, oh, yeah, Alina went for...
She wanted most likely to develop a drug addiction was Anna. Alright, so Anna, you're the dumbest. You come with me, and the rest of you. You did a good job, and you're gonna come back later today and find out who the winner is and who the mole is, so we'll see you then.
Okay.